God for the precious saints of God.
Amen.
This meeting has been so rich and encouraging.
Amen.
The testimonies, as the brother was saying, just enriching our hearts. Thank God to be with the saints of God here in Springfield. Thank God for blessing us. Amen. There in Georgia, the Lord is keeping us.
Amen.
By His grace.
Amen.
Giving us strength and help.
Yes.
Amen. The battle is hot, long, and hard, but God's given us grace.
Amen.
We're yet standing on God's strength and His mercy tonight. Thank God for the precious saints here in Springfield, the wonderful congregation here in Springfield. We love all the precious saints of God.
Amen.
Thank God for just being so good to me, saving me, keeping me saved, the determination to press on. Thank God for my precious family, my wife, beautiful wife for 14 years. And amen. Five lovely children. God is good.
Amen.
I have no complaints. No complaints. Amen. My only desire is to be what God would have for me to be. We covet your prayers here in Columbus. The Lord would continue to bless us. Amen. Thank God for what He is doing. But we still covet your prayers. The Lord would continue to help us as we press on. We ask for you to turn your Bibles with us to 1 Chronicles. Chapter number 15. I asked Robert to read for us, please. Robert, bring.
Praise God.
First Chronicles, chapter number 15. And begin reading at verse number 11.
And David called for Zadok and Abiathar the priests, and for the Levites.
And for the Levites.
For Uriah.
And Uriel.
Uriel. Asaiah.
And Asaiah.
And Joel.
And Joel.
Shimeiah.
Shimeiah.
And Eliel.
And Eliel. Come on.
And Abinadab.
Come on.
And said unto them.
And said unto them.
Ye are the chief of the fathers.
Ye are the chief of the fathers of the Levites.
Sanctify yourselves.
Sanctify yourselves.
Both ye and your brethren.
Both ye and your brethren.
That ye may bring up the ark of the Lord God of Israel.
That ye may bring up the ark of the Lord God of Israel.
Unto the place that I have prepared.
Unto the place that I have prepared for it.
For because ye did it not at the first.
Or because ye did it not at the first.
The Lord our God.
The Lord our God made a breach upon us.
For that we sought him not.
For that we sought him not after the due order.
So the priests and the Levites sanctified.
So the priests and the Levites sanctified themselves.
To bring up the ark of the Lord.
To bring up the ark of the Lord God of Israel.
And the children of the Levites.
And the children of the Levites bear the ark of God
upon their shoulders,
upon their shoulders,
with the staves thereon,
with the staves thereon,
as Moses commanded,
according to the word of the Lord.
According to the word of the Lord.
Here in this passage of scripture, we find where David had desired to bring the ark of the covenant, amen, back to Jerusalem. His whole endeavor was to have the ark restored in a rightful place where it belonged. And we recall even in their first attempt, there had been a mishap. Something had befallen Israel because of the manner in which they had brought up the ark originally. But here in their second attempt, amen, David had reminded them, he said, now, because we did not do it at the first, in verse number 13, the Lord our God made a breach upon us. For that we sought him not after the due order. And then he went on and said in verse 14, so the priests and the Levites sanctified themselves to bring up the ark of the Lord God of Israel. And the children of the Levites bear the ark of God upon their what?
Shoulders.
Their shoulders.
Yeah.
With the staves thereon, as Moses commanded according to the word of the Lord. We would like to speak on the thought this evening. The weight of glory.
Amen.
The weight of glory. Here in this account, David has failed in his first attempt. When you go back to chapter number 13 of 1 Chronicles, you'll find where the Bible says, and starting at verse number 5, David was beginning his course in desiring to bring the ark back. And let's look at what happened here. Verse number 5, 1 Chronicles 13 and 5.
So David gathered
all Israel together
from Shihor,
come on,
even unto the entering of Hamath.
Come on,
to bring the ark of God from Kirjath-Jearim.
Yes.
And David went up.
David went up.
And all Israel.
All of Israel.
To Baalah.
To Baalah.
That is.
Yes.
Kirjath-Jearim.
Yes.
Which belonged
to Judah.
To bring up thence.
To bring up thence the ark of God. Ark of God the Lord. Come on.
That dwelt between
which dwelt between the cherubims.
Whose name is called on it. And they carried the ark of God in a new cart out of the house.
They began to carry the ark of God upon a new ark. A new cart. The Bible says in another passage how Ahio was in the front. And Uzzah was in the back. And as he was in the front, he wasn't aware of what was going on in the back. And the ark of God was resting upon these calves on this new ark, this new cart. And as Uzzah began to see the ark beginning to shift, he reached his hand out to steady the ark. But the moment he touched that thing, he lost his life. And what happened was David was grieved. He said, Lord, what's going on? Why is it that when, amen, we were endeavoring to do your work, we were endeavoring to bring the ark, amen, back to Jerusalem. We wanted to have your presence among us, but there took place a situation that caused you to be grieved at us.
Right. Yes.
And David, he began to seek God. He began to turn his plate over. He began to get God's attention. Lord, what's going on? But here's the thing. The reason why there was a breach and the reason why there was a problem was because when they began to bring up the ark, they were bringing up the ark according to the mannerisms that the Philistines had brought the ark.
Amen.
In other words, amen, if you start off with something wrong, it's going to end wrong. If you try to deal with the situation and you start it wrong, it's going to end wrong.
Right.
And what God was saying was, amen, if you start right and stay right, you'll end right. Saints of God, that's our desire when it comes to the glory of God. We want the God's presence and his glory to work among us, but we got to do it the right way. And the Bible lets us know here, amen, in verse number 7, and they carried the ark of God on a new cart. Come on.
Out of the house of Abinadab. And Ahio
drave the cart.
And David and all Israel played before God.
Then they started rejoicing. They were praising God. Glory to God. Amen. We see God's amen working. We want God to move among us. Man, praise God. God is doing good things. And they were rejoicing and shouting. But what happened? Come on.
And David and all Israel played before God.
David and all Israel played before God with all their might.
And with singing.
Uh-huh.
And with harps.
Yes.
And with psalteries. And with timbrels.
Yes.
And with cymbals. And come with on. Trumpets.
And with trumpets.
And when they came into the threshing floor of Chidon.
And when they came to the threshing floor of Chidon.
Uzzah put forth his hand. To hold the ark. For the oxen stumbled. And the anger of the Lord was kindled against Uzzah.
Come on.
And he smote him.
See, what happened was, they started this course by putting the ark upon a new cart. Well, if you recall, way back in the days of Eli, the Bible says when his eyes began to grow dim, the Bible says, ere the lamp of the Lord went out.
Yes.
And the Bible says that Eli had not restrained his sons. They were sons of Belial, amen. They were Baal, amen. They were doing things in the temple that they ought not to be doing. And so what happened was because, amen, God had began to withdraw his presence from them, amen, they went into battle thinking that God was with them. They thought that God was going to work with them. Man, they went out against the Philistines in that first attempt. I believe about 3,000 lost their lives. They said, we're going to go back to the, amen, to the camp of God, and we're going to bring the ark of God out, and we're going to go out against them, and we're going to beat them. Man, they went back and they got the ark. They went back into the battle, and what happened? Man, the Bible says, I believe it was about 30,000 of them that lost their lives. Man, the word came back to Eli. He said, the Philistines, amen, they slaughtered Israel. He said, your two sons, amen, Hophni and Phinehas, amen, they're dead. And the ark of God is what? He said, it was taken away. And who was that? Phinehas' wife. She was upon her bed, amen, ready to deliver. Man, she brought forth that child, and they tried to encourage her. Oh, you got a newborn child. She said, I'm not worried about this child. Man, don't you realize that the glory is departed from Israel? The glory is departed. Why? Amen. Because there was something going on that was not right. And my God, amen, as she bore that child, and she named that child Ichabod. Amen. Why? Because the glory had departed from Israel. But what happened? The Israelites, they started being vexed by the ark of God being in their camp. And so what did they do? They said, well, we're going to move it here, move it there. Amen. But everywhere they moved it, Emirahs. And amen, they were plagued with one thing after another. So you said, you know what we're going to do? We're going to put this, amen, ark upon a new cart. We're going to, amen, put some new, amen, oxen on it, and we're going to let that thing go. And when they let that thing go, I believe that thing came to the house of Abinadab, and that thing rested there, and God blessed his house. And that's when David recognized, hold up, we need the presence of God. But saints of God, here's the thing. We, in this last and evil day, got to recognize the weight of glory. This thing is more than just a joke. This is more than, amen, some plaything. We're dealing with the presence of God Almighty. The Bible says, don't you know it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God? Amen. And what happened is, amen, David did not go after God in the manner that he should. And when they started to bring the ark of God back into Israel, there was a breach. And tonight, what we are seeing is where God will allow there to be a casualty or anything else if you don't follow him at the new word. To not do according to what God's word requires and according to what God demands, you'll find that God will withdraw him from his presence. Amen. Amen. And you know, while the ark of God was when the Philistine camp, what happened? They put it into the house of Dagon. And when they put the ark of God into the house of Dagon, y'all remember that first night, amen, they came in the next morning and Dagon had fallen off his stand. They said, what had happened here? So they lifted up Dagon, amen, and put him back upon his stump. And the Bible says in the next morning when they came back in, amen, he had fallen back to the earth, his head was cut off, and his hands was cut off. You say, well, what does that mean? Well, don't you know that, see, that was their false god. The Bible says over in Revelation that, amen, the Protestant movement, when they were talking about, he said that they are going to have, amen, the doctrine in their forehead and the fellowship in their hands. In other words, God is saying, amen, if you put me in the presence of that which is not right, I'm going to let you know what is right. Yes. Come on. Right. Amen. And saints of God, it's a blessing. Amen. God will let you know what is right. Right. Amen. Amen. People want to, amen, coexist, amen, God's presence with, amen, their own doctrine, their own thoughts, their own mindset, but God's going to show what's right. And when he magnified himself, amen, his head was cut off, his hand was cut off. In other words, God is saying, amen, if I'm going to be in your presence, amen, I'm not going to have no fellowship with any false doctrine. I'm not going to have fellowship with any false ideologies. I'm not going to have any fellowship with that which is not akin to the Spirit of God. Amen. 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 My God, they was astonished, amen, seeing their God fall into the earth. And finally, they sent the ark of God out. But here's the thing, saints of God. When you go back, now let's follow here. Still there in chapter number 13, verse number 9. What does the Bible say?
And when they came into the threshing floor of Chidon.
And when they came to the threshing floor of Chidon.
Uzzah put forth his hand.
Uzzah put forth his hand to hold the ark.
For the oxen stumbled.
For the oxen had stumbled. Let me tell you something. The weight of glory. God never intended for the weight and the responsibility of the glory of God to be upon some dumb, I use that word dumb in the sense of not able to speak, beast. Are you with me? God never intended on the glory of God to rest on beast. Well, what does it mean by beast? Well, Paul said over in 1 Corinthians chapter number 15, he said, I fought with all manner of what? And who was he talking about when he said he fought with all manner of beasts? Amen. False prophets. Amen. Those that have fallen away from the true gospel. In other words, amen, if the ark of God, amen, was going, amen, to be moved, it could not be moved by those, amen, that have fallen short of the glory of God. Amen. We're dealing in a day and age where people are trying to carry the gospel or carry the glory of God, and they themselves are not qualified to carry the gospel. Amen. Over in another place, I believe, Jude, he said, amen, he said, these men, they were brutal beasts. In other words, he said, the glory of God, the weight of this responsibility should not be on that which is carnal. Yes. Should not be on that which is not up to the standard of the gospel. And listen, listen. So what happened? When the ark of God, which is representing of the glory of God and the presence of God, when it rested on that which was not right, what happened? There was a stumble. It stopped the church from going forward. It stopped the forward progress. And David said, hold up, you mean to tell me we try to get God's presence, we try to get God's glory, saints of God, amen, this thing cannot, amen, rest on that which is carnal, that which is earthly, as the brother was talking about the other night, amen, amen, that which is not, amen, directly from God. If God's presence and glory is going to work in his church, it got to rest on the shoulders of those that are sanctified. The weight of the glory of God must rest on that which God has sanctioned and God has put a stamp of approval on. That's the only way the church is going to go forward. Man, let me tell you something. Amen. All along the way. Amen. Whenever there was a situation, amen, where God's glory was hindered, God's glory was stopped, amen, it was because there was something that was not right. It was something that was amiss. And God said, you got to deal with it.
Yes, sir.
But here's the thing, saints of God. The glory of God doesn't just rest on one or two people.
That's right.
The responsibility of the weight of God's church just don't rest on a few people. It rests on every saint of God. How do you say, well, the Levites? Well, yeah, it says the Levites. So we understand the Levites were representative of the ministry. But the Bible says we are all kings and priests. In other words, church, amen, the glory of God rests on every single one of us doing what we're supposed to do.
That's right.
In other words, amen, people say, well, I'm going to leave it to the ministry. I'm going to leave it to this one, amen, to carry the glory. No, we all have a personal responsibility, amen, to lift, amen, up the glory of God, lift up the standard of God, rest it upon our shoulders, and do what God would have for us to do.
That's right.
My God, amen, it's time out. Amen, it used to be where, amen, people would just lay back and sit back and take it easy. Amen, but thanks of God, amen, God is looking for a consecrated people, amen, of people that are sanctified, of people that would die out to this world, amen, die out to the flesh, die out to themselves, and say, God, I'm going to carry my part of the responsibility of carrying the glory of God. Amen, it just don't rest on the older saints. Of Chidon, Uzzah put forth his hand to hold the ark. And what happened?
For the oxen stumble.
Let me tell you something. Amen. As long as there is carnality,
yes.
As long as there's things that's not right, then you will stumble.
Yes, sir.
Amen. People wonder why they can't keep a victorious experience. Amen. They wonder why they can't stay steady. Amen. And be triumphant in their daily walk with God. It's because there's something that's not right and it needs to be dealt with. Amen. You need to lay on the altar until God can sanctify you. Amen. Purge you of that old man. Amen. Get all that imperfection out of you. Amen. Lay before God until you deliver from all of self. Amen. Selfish indulgence. Selfish gratification. Amen. Selfish. Amen. Indifference. What I want to do. No. Amen. You got to allow God to sanctify you wholly.
Yes, yes, yes.
Amen. The Bible says that the oxen stumbled. Come on, verse 10.
And the anger of the Lord was kindled against Uzzah.
And the anger of the Lord
was kindled against Uzzah.
Yes.
And he smote him.
Because
he put his hand to the ark.
And
there he died before
and
God.
Come on.
Before God.
Read on.
And David was displeased.
Because
the Lord had made a breach upon Uzzah. Wherefore that place is called Perazzah to this day. And David was afraid of God that day.
Yes.
Saying, how shall I bring the ark of God home
to me? Listen to David's question. He said, how shall I bring the ark of God home? Church, my God, that's the question of the hour. My God, Lord, we want to see your glory. My God, we want to see you work, amen, even in a greater measure. Amen. He said, how am I going to bring the ark of God home? That's the issue tonight, saints of God. My God, amen, we look at, amen, we say, Lord, amen, there's been situations that's been, amen, amiss among us. Amen, the church has been going through some trials. Amen, but Lord, amen, we want to see you work. And David asked the question, he said, Lord, how are we going to bring the ark of God home? And the answer tonight is, you got to put the weight of glory on your own shoulders. Are you hearing me tonight?
Yes.
Church of God, we got to hold the standards, amen, not just the ministry, but every single one.
Amen.
Amen. And what so excited me, amen, tonight and throughout this meeting, amen, if you go and see how David brought the ark back when he got, amen, the priest right, amen, when everybody got sanctified, amen, when people got, amen, things cleared up, amen, apologies was made, amen, all type of attitudes was removed, amen, things that was not right, amen, they got it all cleared out the way. When they started bringing back the ark, what happened? They would take 6 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And when they took 6 steps, what did they do? Man, they set the ark down and they started shouting. Y'all ever read that before? They set the ark down and they started shouting. In other words, we have not gotten all the way where we want to be. But Lord, you haven't made another breach. Lord, you're working with me up to this point. Lord, I'm endeavoring to keep your word. Lord, amen, I went through an affliction in my body and I stood for you. And now I can shout. Lord, I had somebody come against me. Amen, they tried me. They got, amen, they tried to, amen, call the response out of me. But Lord, I kept the victory. I'm going to shout. Come on, saints of God. I hear the testimony of the saints. Amen, Brother White's testimony. Amen, you take 6 steps. Amen, then you start shouting. Amen, Sister Ella's testimony. Amen, of her grandson. You take 6 steps. You start shouting. In other words, Lord, I'm getting closer and closer. But as I'm walking closer, my God, I gotta stop and give God some glory. Give God some glory. And church of God, I believe that's what this meeting is all about. Amen, Lord, amen, I see where you want to take us. I see where you want to go. And what you want to do with us. Amen, Lord, amen, we're traveling. Amen, we're abide of grace. Amen, we want to carry the glory of God as we all do. And Lord, as you show us, we'll walk
in.
My God, you might take a few steps.
Help us.
Amen, put that ark down and start praising God.
Let's shout.
Lord, you kept me another, amen, another year. Amen, when I look at all the saints, amen, those that God saved recently. My God says to God, that's reason to shout.
Amen.
The bodies have been healed.
Yeah.
That's a reason to shout.
Yeah.
Amen. Deliverance that's been wrought. Amen. That's a reason to shout.
Yeah.
Saints of God, amen. I know the church has gone through some things, but the moment you see, you start seeing God working. And God, David said, hold up. I got to put the ark down so I can give it.
my shadow.
That's going to carry this thing on their shoulders. In other words, I got a personal responsibility. Amen. Stop looking at everybody else to carry the glory. Amen. Stop looking at everybody else to hold the standard high. No, you hold the standard. Amen. You do what you're supposed to do. Amen. You stand for God when everybody else is falling. My God, I'm reminded of, amen, who was that? A young man, Phinehas, I believe. Man, the children of Israel were going through a situation, and God was, amen, trying to restore Israel. But then this Midianitish woman, amen, this chief of the elder's son, amen, was in the tent doing things they should have been doing. Man of Phinehas, he says, you know what? I'm going to put the weight of glory on my shoulder.
Come on.
Hold on. You need to tell me you playing around, you doing things you know you ain't supposed to be doing. Amen. And we're just going to, amen, just turn a blind eye and let things go that should not be going. He said, hold on. I'm going to put the weight of glory on my shoulder. And he walked up in there, pulled that javelin out, and thrust him through. The man threw his back, and the woman threw through her belly. That should tell you what was going on. He said, I'm going to put the weight of glory on my shoulders. Right. Amen. Amen. And what happened here? See, the issue is people they want God's presence, but they want to take a stand when it's time to take a stand.
That's right.
They want God to work with them, but when it's time, amen, to thrust something through, amen, let me tell you something. It takes, amen, every single person to put the weight on their shoulder and say, you know what? I'm against it just like God and everybody else.
That's right, bro.
Amen.
That's right, right.
I recall even David said, I'm going to put the weight of glory on my shoulders. Man, he was there feeding his father's sheep. His father said, go check on your brothers. Amen. Go bring them provisions. And David said, okay, father. He went and he checked on them. And he said, brother, how goes the battle? And they said, David, what you been doing? Wait, who did you leave those sheep with? He said, well, father told me to come and check on you all. He said, now who's this uncircumcised for this? Are you going to tell me that the Israel is in battle and all y'all standing back? Nobody wants to put the weight on their shoulders?
That's right.
Let's go.
Come on.
Say to God, even young people tonight, we need some young people that will put the weight of glory on their shoulders. Amen. There's no double standard. Amen. Amen. Young people, worldly and carnal and, amen, full of compromise. No. Amen. It's time for everybody to put the weight on their own shoulders. David, he walked into the camp. He said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Why y'all just standing here?
Yes.
Man, Eliab, his old eldest brother, he got mad. He said, won't you go on back home? David said, is there not a cause?
Amen.
Don't you realize, amen, that the glory of God is going to depart from Israel if we don't deal with this problem right here?
Amen.
I don't care how big the problem, it's a problem, and it's stopping Israel from going forward.
Yes, right.
My God. And he said, hold up. He said, I'm going to put the weight of glory on my own shoulders. All y'all big boys, y'all should be in the battle. Y'all should be going, amen, after Goliath. Amen. He's been withstanding y'all for year after year after year. He said, who's going to put the weight on their own shoulders?
That's right.
That's what God is looking for tonight. Yeah. Who's going to put it on their own shoulders tonight?
That's right, man.
My God and David, amen, Eliab, amen, they called and said, Saul wants to talk to you. And David went in there. He said, Saul, he said, I know I'm young. And he said, but this uncircumcised Philistine. And Saul said, now what can you do?
Come on.
And David said, you know what? I was in the field. And there was a lion and a bear. And it took one of my ewe lambs. Now, here's the thing, thanks to God. It's hard to imagine this. And in the picture books, they always tell you that it was two separate lambs. But when you study the Word of God, it really don't look like there was two lambs. You read it for yourself. You study it for yourself. But the Bible says David, every time he relayed the situation, he would say, there came a lion and a bear and took a lamb.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
David was something else. He dealt with a lion and a bear simultaneously to deliver one little lamb. And David said, I know what God has done for me in the past. And I got the weight of glory on my shoulder. And my God, amen, we're going to go and we're going to take this Philistine captive. My God, the Bible says that he went before that thing. He said, amen, I don't come with you in spear, with sword. He said, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. My God, he took those five smooth stones. Amen. He did a work upon that giant. All I'm saying this tonight, saints of God, is God wants a people that's going to put the weight of glory on their own shoulders.
Right.
Amen. Stop looking at for everybody else. Amen. Stop leaning on the arms of the ministry and saying, oh, we're going to let them do it. No. Amen. It is all of our responsibility to carry the weight of glory.
That's right.
Tonight, I'm reminded even of Epaphroditus turned to Philippians. This young man,
yes. He
was carrying the weight of glory. Yes. I want to encourage you tonight, saints of God, every single one of us,
amen,
from the oldest to the youngest, ministry, amen, young people, amen, married people, amen, single people, that today, amen, tonight, amen, it's time to carry the weight of glory, amen, we're in the last of the last days, amen, God is coming back for a glorious church, amen, all this stumbling and carnality, amen, all these problems that's stopping the church from going forward, amen, God said, I will eliminate before I allow a new cart to bring the glory.
Yes.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes.
He said, I will eliminate before I allow a new thing to come along and try to bring, amen, what this thing is all about. In other words, we got to get back to the old pattern.
Yes.
We got to get back to what worked in the old days.
Yes.
Amen. The saints of God, amen, they prayed and humbled themselves. Amen. They called on God. Amen. They waited on God. They trusted God. Amen. They prayed afflictions down. Amen. Through. Amen. They prayed up. Amen. Healing down.
Yes. Yes.
That's what worked in the old days.
That's right.
Amen.
My God, they were so busy. Amen. On all type of, amen, social media networks. And, amen. They were locked in before God.
That's right.
Amen. Praying before God. Yes. What were they doing? They put the weight of glory on their own shoulders.
Glory to God.
That's, my God. See, sometimes you sit back and people recall the old days, the old days. You know what was going on? It was individuals that was carrying the weight themselves.
Yes. Right. Yes.
My God, you can mention one name after another. Man, the other day, we was at Sister Kennedy's house. And we're talking about Sister Walker. Talking about Sister Smite.
Yes.
Talking about these old saints. What were they doing? They were carrying the weight of glory on their own shoulders.
Right.
My God, we talk about Mother Green there in Jackson. Amen. We talk about Brother Johnson, different ones. Amen. Who were deep in the faith. Amen. What were they doing? They were carrying the weight of glory. They weren't looking at everybody else. Amen. Flopping and flapping it. Amen. Giving in and letting down. No. They were holding the standard.
Right.
My God, that's what God is coming back for. A people. Amen. Young, old. Amen. No matter who your status, who's going to carry the weight of glory.
Yes.
Amen. Turn to, what did I say?
Right.
Philippians chapter number 1.
My Lord, my Lord.
Chapter 2.
Praise the Lord.
Verse number 25.
Yet I suppose it necessary.
The weight of glory is to rest on the shoulders of consecrated ministers and consecrated saints of God. That's what it's all about. When David went back to the law, and he recognized how the ark was to be moved. Moses had written and said that the ark, which was a wooden box, overlaid with gold. It was a cherubim on one side and another cherubim on the other. Their wings overshadowed the mercy seat. And within the ark was the golden pot of manna, Aaron's rod that budded, and the tables of the covenant. And the Bible says, amen, that when you move the ark, there's going to be golden rings on the side of the ark. And I want you to place the pole through the rings of the ark. And as you carry the ark, you're to lift it up and to put it on your shoulders. When you carry my glory, it's going to rest on your shoulder. You're the one that's responsible for the glory. I'm not looking at, oh, Brother Leah, of God, the weight of it, the weight on our shoulders. What does the Bible say, verse number 25?
Yet I suppose it necessary.
I suppose it necessary.
To send to you Epaphroditus.
Come on.
My brother and companion in labor.
Yes.
And fellow soldier.
Uh-huh.
But your messenger.
Yes.
And he that ministered to my wants.
Come on.
For he longed after you all.
Yes.
And was full of heaviness.
Yes.
Because that he had heard that he had been sick.
He had been sick.
For indeed he was sick nigh unto
death. Listen at this brother and how he carried his weight.
Oh, my Lord.
Come on.
For indeed he was sick nigh unto death.
For indeed he was sick. Come on.
But God had mercy on him.
He was nigh unto death, but God had mercy on him.
And not on him only.
And not on him only.
But me
on me. But on me also.
Lest I should have sorrow
upon sorrow.
I send him therefore the more carefully.
Come on.
That when you see him again.
When you see him again.
He may rejoice.
He may rejoice.
And that I may be the less sorrowful.
Come on.
Receive him therefore
the Lord with all gladness.
And hold such
a in reputation.
Because for the work of Christ.
Listen.
He was not unto death.
Because for the work of Christ.
He was nigh unto death.
This man was nigh unto death.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Not regarding his life.
He was not regarding his life. The Bible says over in Luke chapter number 17 that he that seeketh to save his life shall lose it. But he that loses his life for my sake shall find it. In other words, this man had got so under the weight of the glory of God that he almost lost his own life because of how serious he took the glory of God.
That's right, brother.
My Lord.
Saints of God, that's what this thing is all about.
Yes, sir.
The problem that we have is too many shoulders are being weighed down with their own problems, with their own cares, with their own situations that they're not in position like Epaphroditus was to carry the weight of the glory of the church. And let's read that last verse again. Because of what?
Because for the work of Christ.
Because of the work of Christ.
He was nigh unto death.
He was nigh unto death.
Not regarding his life.
Man, this man, he was regarding his life.
Come on.
He was regarding, amen, converse. He wasn't regarding, amen, amen, status quo, amen, how I can make things, amen, comfortable for myself. No, amen, he said, I'm bearing the weight of glory, amen, I'm diligent, I'm seeking God, I'm faithful, amen, I'm praying like I should, I'm fasting like I should, amen, I'm laboring before God, amen, I'm praying for the sick, amen, I'm doing the work of God, amen, I'm laying aside all weight, amen, all carnality, all my own fleshly and selfish problems, and I'm going to carry the weight of glory.
Yeah.
Amen. The Bible says he did not regard his life. What was he doing? He was carrying the weight.
My Lord.
Sometimes that weight can get kind of heavy.
Yes. Yes.
The brother was talking about stress. Amen. Sometimes you do. Amen. You might have some stress.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the thing, saints of God. Amen. When you carry the weight of glory, you have the glory.
That's right.
And what I'm seeing tonight and what I'm hearing tonight, glory be to God, is a people that are endeavoring with the help of Almighty God to carry this weight. And saints of God, I'm sorry, I know, amen, we can't apologize for the heaviness of the weight. Sometimes it gets a little heavy. Sometimes, amen, you're carrying a mighty load. Amen, sometimes, amen, you're dealing with situations and you're praying all night. Amen, you're getting phone calls in the middle of the night. And yes, it's a heavy weight, but God will give you grace to carry this weight. Amen, saints of God, amen, God is coming after our people that who have the weight of glory on their shoulders. That's the bottom line. If you put the glory on, amen, on a new cart, if you put the glory down, you know what? It's too hard. It's too heavy. Amen. That's why there's so much compromise in the land.
Yes.
Because carrying the weight of glory sometimes does get a little heavy. Sometimes it gets a little hard. Sometimes it's hard to put another step in front of the other. And all you got to do is, all you can do is just fall on your knees and say, God, give me your grace. And all of a sudden, he gives you strength and you rise back up. And you take another step. Glory be to God. Say to God, sometimes the load does get heavy. Sometimes, amen, you got to cry. Sometimes you gotta say, I love you, amen, I care about you, but I can't go along with your wrong. people may change. People may back up on this gospel.
Come on, brother.
Amen. People may compromise on this gospel.
That's right.
My God, God is looking for people that's going to be carrying the weight of the Lord.
That's right. That's right.
That's what God is coming back for. People that's carrying the weight.
That's right.
The weight of it. Amen. Who's going to carry the weight tonight? That's what God wants. Who's going to carry the weight tonight? Amen. Not back up on God. Not say, you know what, this thing got a little too hard. And, amen. I'm going to take it easy. Amen. Like, who was that? Demas?
Right.
He don't for St. Paul.
Right.
Love the present world. What did he do? He put the ark down.
That's right.
It's too much, man. Went back and rested. No. Paul said, bring me John Mark.
Come on, bro.
Maybe he set it down at one time. But bring me John Mark. He's profitable unto me. Yeah. For the ministry.
Yeah.
In other words, he put the weight back on his shoulder. He said, I'm going to carry with you, Paul. Paul, I know you and Barnabas was out working. I went back home. Maybe I didn't know that the work was this hard and this rigorous. He said, but you know what? I'm going to put the weight back on my shoulder.
No.
And then tonight, saints of God, that's what God is looking for.
Yeah.
A people that will carry the weight of glory on your own shoulder.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says here, because of the work of God, because of the work of God, this man's physical frame was given out because of the spiritual load of a weight of glory that he was carrying. Saints of God, this is what God is looking for. Turn with me to 2 Corinthians chapter number 3.
My Lord.
2 Corinthians chapter number 3, verse number 4.
And such trust have we through Christ, through Godward.
Yes.
Not that we are sufficient of ourselves.
Not that we are sufficient of ourselves.
To think anything as of ourselves.
Come on.
But our sufficiency is of God.
Our sufficiency is of God.
Who also has made us able ministers.
Who also have made us able ministers.
Of the New Testament.
Of the New Testament.
Not of the letter.
See, listen. See, that's why I thank God for the ministry.
Yes, sir.
And thank God for those that would carry the weight of glory and inspire the saints of God in carrying the weight as well.
My Lord.
It takes an inspired ministry to inspire the hearts of the people in order for them to carry the weight.
That's right.
In other words, amen, the saints of God will not carry the weight that the ministry is not carrying. Amen. The ministry has a responsibility that through the help of Almighty God, that we put the weight upon our shoulders, and the saints, when they see the weight upon your shoulders, amen, then they will step in and say, you know what? My God, amen, we're going to carry that thing right with you.
That's right.
See, that's what happened to Moses. When he was in the midst of battle. My God, and the Bible says, as he, amen, held up his hands, the Israelites were winning the battle.
That's right.
But when his arms got a little heavy,
yes,
they started losing.
Right.
And the Bible says that Moses and, I'm sorry, Aaron and Hur, man, they went one on each side.
Yeah.
That's right.
They sat him down on a little stool and a stone, and they just held up his hands.
Lord.
In other words, Moses said, I'm carrying the weight of glory myself, and sometimes it gets a little heavy.
That's right.
And that's why it's good to pray for your ministry.
That's right.
And it's good to encourage them. It's good to let them know, amen, brother, amen, I'm standing, I'm holding this thing right along with you.
That's right, brother.
And my God, amen, when they saw, amen, Moses standing, when they saw Moses holding up his with the weight of glory, amen, they said, we're going to hold it right up with you. Thanks to God, that's what the church of God is all about.
That's right, man.
That's what it's all about. And the Bible says, able ministers of the New Testament. In other words, able to do what? Able to carry the weight.
That's right.
That's what this thing is all about.
Right.
Who is able to carry this weight?
Come on.
That's what it, see, a lot of people want to throw their hat in the ring. Oh, amen. Minister this, minister. Hold up. Who's able to carry the weight of this thing?
That's all right.
That's right.
This thing don't jump six or nothing. Because here's the thing. He said, now, able minister the New Testament, but you got, if you're being careful, unable. Or you may have disabled.
Right.
You with me tonight?
That's right.
God is saying, no, we need able. Able ministers of the New Testament.
That's all right.
Of the New Testament. Why? To carry this weight. Church of God, this thing is more than just, amen, just some organization. This thing is not a denomination.
Amen.
This thing is not some, amen, groupism, as the brother we're talking about earlier. Amen. This is, amen, the church of the living God. Amen. Who was born of God. Amen. Sit down from God, as the Bible says in Revelation 21 or so. Amen. Having the glory of God. Amen. That's what this thing is all about. When he sent Zion down from heaven, he sent it down with the glory of God. And he has called you and I, amen, the saints of God in the days of old, amen, in the days of the morning time, they carried their weight. Amen. Those that went through, amen, they carried it through the apostasy. Amen. They carried their weight. Amen. Those that were in the time, amen, of the Catholic Church and all the rule and all, amen, all the persecution, they carried their weight. There were those that took their stand out of Protestantism, amen, took their stand for the one true church of the living God. They carried their weight, and now we are come down to this final hour, and God is calling for a people that would carry the weight. That's what it's all about. And you look over land, what do you see? Compromise after compromise, let down after let down. What happened? Amen. People at one time were carrying the weight, but it got too heavy. The pressure got too hard. Amen. Situations got too close, and they started backing up. And when they backed up, they put it down. And now, no glory in the camp. No glory in the camp. The saints of God, what is just a blessing. That's why I want to encourage your hearts tonight. What I heard tonight was saints of God taking six paces. And giving God some glory.
That's right.
I don't know if some of y'all read that. Let's look at that. Just for a second. I'm about to close. I'm about to close, but go to, I believe that's 2 Samuel. I didn't write this down in my notes, but I believe it's 2 Samuel. Chapter number 6. Yes.
Bless the Lord.
2 Samuel chapter number 6. And we'll pick up how he left off in Chronicles in verse number 9. 2 Samuel chapter number 6 and verse number 9.
And David was afraid of the Lord that day.
Come on.
And said, how shall the ark of the Lord come to me?
How shall the ark of the Lord come to me?
So David would not remove the ark of the Lord into the city of David.
Yes.
But David carried it aside to the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite.
Come on.
And the ark of the Lord continued.
And the ark of the Lord continued the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite 3 months.
And the Lord blessed Obed-Edom and all his household.
Listen, in other words, wherever the glory of God is, you will be blessed.
Oh yes.
Praise God. That's why I've been so blessed in this meeting, because the ark of God is here in this place. I believe that tonight.
Amen.
If I didn't believe, I wouldn't be here.
That's
right. Are you with me tonight?
That's right.
Amen. And listen, saints of God, sometimes you look and you say, Lord, amen, there's still a place that we want to be. Amen. But where you see, amen, God working, and you see him still working with his people, amen, you got to do what David did and take six steps. And start shouting.
Come on!
Come on! And say to God, I believe that tonight. Come on, let's continue to read. What does the Bible say?
And it was told King David.
It was told King David.
The Lord had blessed the house of Obed-Edom.
My God, amen. I saw, amen, how the saints were taking their stand. I saw how, amen, bodies that were sick were being healed. Yeah. And I heard the testimonies of this one and that one. Amen, how God had turned, amen, afflictions that were, amen, so grievous and sore in their bodies. And God healed them. Amen, God is blessing. Where the ark of God is blessing.
Amen.
Come on and read.
And it was so King David.
And it was old King David.
The Lord had blessed the house of Obed-Edom.
My God, amen. That household, amen, they got rid of all type of, amen, paraphernalia that was disgrace God. Amen. Husband and wife started getting on one accord. Amen. Children started walking in the fear of God. Amen. That household, amen, the ark of God came into that house, David, and maybe that house has been blessed. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Amen. I was blessed, the brother said. Amen. Brother Nathan. Amen. Whole household got saved.
Yeah.
Amen. The ark of God came into the house.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Brother, you better keep the ark of God in your house.
Amen.
Amen. And listen, he said, David, he heard that God was blessing Obed-Edom's house. Amen. Obed-Edom's house. was just full of the blessings of God.
My Lord.
Amen. Bodies was being healed. Amen. Souls was being saved. Amen. In other words, amen, when they came to that location, to the house of God, amen, I saw that this house was being blessed. Maybe where I was, amen, down in Babylon, I wasn't being blessed. But I heard of the church of God and what's going on at this location, that location. God is blessing his people. David, you better take heed now. What's going on? Obed-Edom's house is being blessed. Come on now, read. What does the Bible say?
The Lord has blessed the house of Obed-Edom.
The Lord has blessed the house of Obed-Edom.
And all that pertaineth unto him.
And all that pertaineth unto him.
Because of the ark.
Because of the ark of God.
So David went and brought up the ark of God.
So David went and brought up the ark of God.
From the house
of Obed-Edom.
Into the city of David.
Into the city of David with gladness. Come on.
And it was so.
And it was free. Come on.
And it was so.
It was so.
As David bare the ark of the Lord.
As David bare the ark of the Lord.
Had gone 6 paces.
They gone 6 paces. One,
he sacrificed oxen two, and fatness.
Three. Four. Nobody's dead yet? Five. Everybody's heart still beating. The blood still running warm. God ain't killed nobody. That means we must be doing something right. Six. Right. They put that thing down, they started shouting. God, you still working with me.
Amen.
In other words, if you're doing something wrong, you would already take care. Are you with me? So David recognized now we haven't gotten all the way to Jerusalem, to the city of David. Amen. The place of the threshing floor where the church of God was built.
Yes.
See, in the threshing floor, amen, that was where, when the ark finally rested, that was the very place that the temple was built.
Yes, right.
Which was is the church of God.
Yes.
And in other words, they said, as we're getting back to what this thing is all about, he said, I see God is working with us.
That's right.
And read that verse one more time.
And it was so.
It was so.
That when they that bear the ark of the Lord
they
had gone
that
6 paces.
Bear the ark of the Lord had gone 6 paces.
He sacrificed oxen and fat.
Man, they started sacrificing oxen. Come on.
And David danced.
And then they started, amen, sacrifice. They said, we might, hey, God has blessed us this far. Amen, we're going to give him more. If God has brought us to this point, then my God, what more can I do for y'all? My God, if you're saving household, my God, what more? Amen, can I fast a little more? Can I pray a little more? My God, can I do a little bit more for you, Lord? What more can I do? They started sacrificing. Come on.
And David danced before the Lord.
Man, they started shouting. They started praising God. And that's what's going on. Amen. Tonight. Thanks to God. Amen. Taking 6 paces, they start shouting. God, you done heal my body?
That's right. That's right.
God, you working with me?
That's right.
God, you done save my children? God, you bringing, amen, all type of situations, turning them again. God, you working with us?
Yeah.
I'm here to tell you tonight, God is working with us. I believe that. Not that I'm so great. Amen. But listen to the testimony. God is working with this people. I believe that. Amen. I'm not criticizing or looking down. No. Amen. God is. See, David had not reached Jerusalem, but he was already starting to shout. I know that when they were building Jerusalem's temple, there was a conflict of the noise. The old were mourning. The young were shouting. But when you really think about it, the young had not known anything.
Right.
That's right.
But God was still trying to work with them.
That's right.
And all I'm saying tonight, saints of God, is God is working with us, but we got to make sure, amen, as we keep going, that we dot the I's, we cross the T's, amen, don't get involved with anything that's questionable, amen, refrain from all false doctrine, amen, false brethren, amen, things that's not of God, amen, sacrifice it, get rid of it, and God will keep working with us. I believe that tonight. What you hear tonight is only because God is working with us. I believe that. Amen. You talk about healing and people taking stands. Amen. Amen. Sister Val back at home. Amen. Her father's a Baptist preacher and everything else. Amen. She taking her stand for divine healing. Amen. Trust in God. Let me tell you something. That's because God is working with his people.
That's right.
She done seen something that she's convinced about.
That's right.
Come on. Man, got a big old church. Amen. She the pianist of the church and everything else. Took her stand out of battle. Why? Because she's seen the glory of God. And listen, listen, all kinds of storms and things that we're weathering, amen, and God is still bringing that little child through. Amen, why? Because, amen, the weight of glory is upon our shoulders. Amen. Amen. Read on, what does the Bible say?
And it was so that when they bear the ark of the Lord and gone 6 paces, he sacrificed oxen and fattens. And David danced before the Lord with all his might.
David danced before the Lord with all of his might.
And David was girded with a linen ephod.
Come on.
So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet.
Yes.
And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michael saw his daughter look through a window and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord, and she despised him in her heart.
And listen, in her punishment for despising him, she had no children. She was barren for the rest of the day. You mean to tell me that you want to despise what God is doing? You mean to tell me that you want to count what God is doing as naught? And discredit it? Let me tell you something. Anybody discrediting what God is doing, amen, let me tell you something. You're going to be in trouble with God. You're going to be in trouble with God. Because this is God's doing. And people, they play games, and they don't understand the weight and the severity of the thing. And what God is doing, you better don't touch it. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. You leave this thing to God. God's in control of this thing. God orders his church. Amen. We're nothing. We can be removed in a heartbeat. We're nothing. Amen. I just want to fall in line. She started to despise him. Man, listen, you should have been out there helping carry the glory. You should have been out there doing your part. I want to criticize. We ain't got time for that. We ain't got time for criticism. We need encouragement. We need to be uplifted. Amen. The saints have been going through some serious, amen, hard, amen, difficult, amen, mind-boggling battles. Amen. Going through some the trenches, as it were. Amen. We need God.
And they brought in the ark of the Lord.
They brought in the ark of the Lord.
And set it in his place.
In other words, they made it to the final destination. The saints of God, that's where God is carrying us. To that place where his glory can rest completely among us. So what do? As God is working with us, we keep checking ourselves. We keep looking. We keep sacrificing. They took 6 paces, they sacrificed. They took 6 more paces, they kept sacrificing. In other words, you mean to tell me that God is working to this measure? Then you know what? I'm not going to spend so much time on the internet. You know what? I'm not going to spend so much time, amen, wondering what the latest, amen, CNN news is.
That's right.
I ain't talking about TV, I'm talking about church news network.
Amen.
Wow.
Hello.
Amen.
What more can I sacrifice?
That's right, brother.
Amen, I spend so much of my money and, amen, all of, amen, my assets on this and that. Amen, what can I do more for the kingdom?
Oh, Lord.
Amen. That's good. Thanks to God, that's what this thing is all about. As you see God is working, amen, you keep sacrificing, you keep laying aside, you keep saying, Lord, what more can I do for you? By God, and then when you get to Acts, amen, the Bible says over, amen, in Acts chapter number 4. Let's turn to Acts chapter number 4 as we begin to close here. But tonight, thanks to God, we are encouraging each and every one of us to carry the weight of glory on your shoulders. Acts chapter number 4 and verse number 23.
And being let go, they went to their own company.
In other words, the brethren had been in prison. They had gone through a battle. They were in a difficult situation. But God was working with them. Listen, saints of God, just because you may go through some battles don't mean that God is not with you.
That's right.
It just means that God is perfecting you.
Yeah.
And so as they went through this situation, man, God was working with them, but it seemed like they had a backset. And it seemed like, amen, in their situation, it seemed like maybe, Lord, have we lost some ground? Amen, as they were carrying the weight of glory. But the Bible, amen, encourages and says, and being let go, they went to their own company, come on.
And reported all that the chief priests and elders had said unto them.
Come on.
And when they heard that,
they lifted up their voice to God with one accord.
And said,
Lord,
thou art God.
My God, the devil gets mad when the church is on the move. The devil gets mad when he starts seeing the saints of God. Amen. Start lifting up that ark. Amen. The ark is lifted up. And they rest that thing on their shoulder. The devil gets upset. Why? Because he sees the people. Amen. That needs and determines to go forward in spite of what he does. Come on and read. Why did the heathen rage? And the people imagined vain things.
The kings of the earth stood up. And the rulers were gathered together
against the Lord and against his Christ.
For I'm true.
Let me tell you something. The devil's mad at anything that will dare to stand for God.
Yes.
The devil's mad at anyone and anybody that would dare take a stand for God. Amen. Those that won't back down, won't back up. Amen. Like the three Hebrew boys. Amen. The Bible says there are certain Jews. Now, what happened to all the other Jews? I don't know. What were they doing? Amen. Were they bowing like everybody else? But the Bible says certain Jews. Amen. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They said, we're going to carry this thing on our own shoulders. I don't know where everybody else is, but we're going to carry this thing on our own shoulders. The king was mad. The heathen, they raged. Amen. And they went on and they said, for of a truth, verse number 27.
For the truth, yes. Against thy holy child Jesus,
yes.
Whom thou hast anointed,
yes.
Both Herod and Pontius Pilate, with the Gentiles, the people of Israel, were gathered together.
Come on.
For to do whatsoever
thy hand and thy counsel determined before it to be done.
And now.
Lord.
Behold their threatening.
Yes.
And grant unto thy servant.
Lord, you see, my God, it says to God, some of us are going through some battles tonight. Some of us are going through some afflictions tonight. Some are going through some heavy hardship. Amen. Some difficult waters. And you say, Lord, behold their threatening.
Yes.
You see what the devil, amen, trying to say. He's saying that I'm not going to make it. He's saying that, amen, you're not going to make it. Amen, you're not going to go another step. But we're going to be praying tonight. And listen, what did he say now?
Thank the Lord.
And now, Lord, behold their threatening.
Behold their threatening.
And grant unto thy servants.
And grant unto thy servants.
That with all boldness.
That with all boldness.
They may speak thy word.
That we might, my God. In other words, Lord, we don't want to let you down. I know the weight is getting heavy. They said they're going to take our life. They said they're going to throw us in jail because of the way we stand. They said they're going to take us to the law, amen, and take our children away because we stand for divine healing. Lord, you hear the prayer. But Lord, we're not going to back up. Read what it says.
And grant unto thy servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word.
That they may speak thy word.
By stretching forth thy hand to heal.
Lord, in other words, show more your glory.
Yeah, come on.
Show more of your glory.
That's right.
My God, and I thank God for the glory that we already have seen and heard tonight.
Amen. Right.
But my God, Lord, stretch forth thy hand and show us more of your glory.
Yes.
In other words, Lord, we're not stopping where we are. I thank you that there are some that have picked up the ark and they're carrying the weight of glory.
Right.
But my God, tonight I believe there's more that want to lift up their weight. They want to get on where they ought to be in order to carry their weight. And keep this thing going. By stretching forth thy hand to heal, come on.
And that signs and wonders may be done by thy womb. By the name of thy holy child Jesus.
Come on.
And when they had prayed.
Now listen. I believe. See, remember that the ark could only rest on the shoulders of the sanctified priest. Are you with me? Of the sanctified priest. And the Bible says that when they have prayed,
the place is shaken.
What happened when they prayed?
The place is shaken.
I believe that there were those saints of God that when they got down on their knees, when they came up with an ark. In other words, Lord, they're threatening us. They're trying to come against us. But Lord, you give us something greater. Lord, you give us something more. And we'll carry our load. They picked up that glory, and the Bible says that the place was shaken. The little building was shaken. What happened? You had people that started carrying the weight of what is being all about. Come on and read.
The place was shaken where they were assembled together. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost.
And they were, by God, they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. By God, God started pouring out His Spirit. And listen, what happened? Come on and read.
And they spake the word of God.
They spake the word of God with boldness.
And the multitude of them that believed.
Amen.
We're of one heart.
There was a one heart.
And of one soul.
Amen. Not all this divided. Amen. Division and strife. And amen. All this and that. But they was all of one heart. Amen. When they got sanctified, everybody was going in the same direction. Amen. The weight was on all the people of God. Amen. They were hearing the word of God. They were obeying the word of God. Amen. They heard the message to come up, and they were going up with the word of God. Come on.
Neither said any of them. That ought of the things which he possessed.
Why got all that selfishness, all that, amen, I wanted my way and do what I want to do, all that went out the window. Amen. My God, what happened? They stopped carrying their own problems. They started carrying, amen, their own selfish, amen, ideas and all what they wanted. And they started carrying the weight of glory.
That's right.
But they had all things common.
They had all things common. Read.
And with great power.
And with what?
With great power.
Listen, God had already been manifesting Himself. They were taking six more steps. And God was just kept pouring it on. The fifth chapter. Another, amen, multitude of souls got saved. Amen. And anybody that came into the camp and that was not right in the fifth chapter, God eliminated them. Are y'all with me tonight?
Sure.
And when He eliminated them, amen, yes, the ark had stopped for a second, but once they was eliminated, they picked the ark back up and they kept on going.
Oh,
and the Bible says multitudes were saved.
Yes.
In other words, saints of God, amen, we don't want to get in the way of the glory.
Amen.
We just want to be a part.
That's right.
Lord, I just want to be a part of this.
Right.
Amen. I know, amen, the enemy, he plagues. He comes, he's an accuser of the brethren. Amen. He's going to try his best to stop you. Saints of God, I know, amen, 2016, amen, many of us have went through some severe battles. We have gone through some things that are in our own imagination we didn't know we were going to go through. Amen. But here's the thing. God is saying, church, I will give you grace. I'll give you strength. Amen. You stay where you're supposed to be. Keep doing what you're supposed to be doing. And lift up the ark. Amen. You carry the glory. And I'll help you and keep you the rest of the way. My God, they lifted that thing up. My God, the saints of the morning time and all that they had to endure, they still kept carrying the ark of the covenant. Tonight, church, in this last and evil day, where you see people backing up on God, people compromising, turning, amen, and getting lukewarm, as it were, amen, not really going all the way with God. Tonight, God is saying, who is willing to take their load, their responsibility, and carry their weight of the glory of God? We all have a personal responsibility in this sense of God.
That's right.
In other words, do you have any skin in the game?
That's right.
They also sometimes get an old narrative, this like a parable, where the farmer told the all the farm animals what he wanted for breakfast. He said, "I want some eggs. I want some milk. I want some ham." So the goat said, I'll give you some milk. He went and got him some milk. The chicken said, I'll give you some eggs. She went and laid her some eggs. The pig pig? The farmer said, I want some ham, man. Give me some ham. The pig said, The chicken gave you some eggs and she keeps on walking. The goat gives you some milk and he keeps on going down his merry way. But when I give you some ham, it's all set. Lay it all down.
That's right.
You come this far.
That's right.
God has saved you.
Yeah.
God has blessed and restored some of your marriages. Amen. God has did this and did that, and now, amen, we're going to give God just a little bit. God said, hold up, no. Amen. Get all that stuff, all this other stuff off your shoulders and pick up the real weight.
That's right.
In other words, sacrifice all yourself and all of you this time to carry the weight of glory. Thanks to God, we're about to enter into 2017. This thing is almost said and done. Amen. This thing is a wrap, as the young people say. Amen. It's almost over.
Yes.
There's nothing else that really matters in this life, thanks to God.
Right.
Money don't matter. House, lands, amen, cars, nothing else really matters in this world anymore. The only thing that matters is whether or not you got the weight of glory on your shoulders.
Right.
And he comes back for his church.
That's
he's
right.
Coming back for a glorious church.
That's right.
Without spot. What is he talking about when he said come back for a glorious church? Church that got the weight on their shoulders.
That's right.
They walk. They might stop at the six steps and start shouting, but they still walk.
Right.
And carry the weight of glory. Tonight, that's what it's all about, church.
That's right.
Who's going to carry the weight of glory? Who's going to carry the weight of glory? You say, tonight, maybe I haven't been carrying my full load. Maybe I've been so busy with life, ripping and running, got cares, got this, got going on. Amen. It's time for me to carry my weight. And here's the thing, thanks to God. Amen. Tonight, God is saying, amen, some things we got to put aside. Some things you got to sacrifice. Some things you got to say, you know what? This is taking too much of my time. I've been giving too much attention to this thing and that thing. Amen. Just like Jesus told the disciples. Amen. They came back. He was at the woman dealing with her at the well. And he told her, amen, about herself. Told her how many husbands she had and who she hadn't had. And so when the disciples came back, they said, Jesus, where's your meat? You know, we were here to bring you. Jesus said, I have meat that you need. No, not us. He said, look upon the fields. They're white already to harvest. He said, y'all busy worrying about the natural food. He said, but you don't realize that I'm carrying the weight of glory. I'm carrying the weight. I'm witnessing. I'm busy trying to, amen, win souls. And by the time he had not finished working to that woman, with that woman, she had confessed Christ. In other words, boys, y'all so busy caring about everything else. I'm busy out here with souls. And that's what it's all about. In other words, who's going to carry their weight? Their souls perishing. Amen. You're saved tonight. Amen. Amen. It's time for you to pick up your weight and carry the load so others can be born into the kingdom of God.
That's right.
Amen. Tonight, church, is what it's all about. You can try to allow beast to carry the glory, but it's not going to get you far.
That's true.
You'll keep stumbling. That's why, listen, I was telling an individual just the other day, somebody, don't matter where you go to church, yes it does. Because every attempt by false religion to carry the glory of God, you'll only stumble. And that's why they only have a religion of stumbling. They have a religion of falling down. They can't help but to fall. Why? Because you have beasts trying to carry the glory, and it won't work.
That's right.
What God is saying tonight, sanctify ministry. Sanctify saints of God. Sanctify young people. Take the weight, rest it on your shoulder.
That's right.
Tonight, may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Psalm number 241 in the evening light. 241, who will suffer? Who will suffer?
The altar is open. The altar is open. Won't you come? Anybody want to carry their weight? Carry their weight tonight. Carry their weight. I want to see the weight of glory. Amen. And put this one on my shoulders. On my shoulders.
Will you come?
Amen.
Will you come tonight? Amen. Will you come? 241. Amen. 241.
Yes, Lord.
Will you come? The altar's open. Don't need to re-preach the message. The Holy Ghost spoke tonight. Who's willing to sacrifice and take away the glory? Is there one more in detail tonight that's willing to do their part? Is there one more that would like to come and pray? We'll pray with you. The whole purpose of being here tonight in fellowship meeting. Is there one more that would like to come and pray tonight? Brother poured out his heart tonight. Amen. And I loaded his burden tonight. Made it plain and simple to each one of us. I need to step up, sacrifice, go a little farther. All of us are going through some things this year. Amen. So the whole purpose of us being here in this meeting tonight. Amen. My God, carrying the weight of glory. Doing your part. Amen. Not looking at the next person, but doing your part. Amen. Are you ready to suffer? Are you willing to sacrifice tonight? Thank God for the message. Amen. The weight of glory. You may be seated, saints. Precious souls are praying. Amen. Amen. Fellowship. Fellowship thy passion. Gladly suffer shame and loss. With thy blessing, pain and pleasure.